Hello friends, in my previous video I was discussing about conversion of AC to DC, right? So for that we use rectifiers, that may be half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier. But anyhow, if you don't use the filter, then generally suppose you consider the output of the full wave rectifier, then it comes like this. This is not exactly DC, this is pulsating DC, and to convert this pulsating DC to exact DC, which exact DC waveform can be shown like this, that is dV dt is equal to 0 for the DC waveform, and for this waveform it is happening there, so that we can say this is a pure DC. So to get the pure DC from the pulsating DC, we pass the pulsating DC through a filter. And in my previous video, I have already shown you two filters and their implementation in multisim, that one of them is series inductor filter and another one is shunt capacitor filter. How they work, how to simulate in multisim, already I explained in detail. You can check the description. I will post the link of my previous those videos. Okay, now let me summarize those concepts again. That is, if you consider this series inductor filter, then in the output of the half wave rectifier, what you do, you just, instead of giving directly RL, you just connect one inductor in series, so that this is called series inductor filter. And why this makes pure DC from pulsating DC? Simple logic was XL is 2 pi FL for this inductor, or we can say the impedance offered by the inductor is j omega L, and for DC, ZL, that is impedance offered by the inductor, will be 0. Why? Because for DC, frequency of oscillation is 0, so omega, that is 2 pi F, will be equal to 0, so ZL will be 0, right? But for AC, the inductor will provide high impedance value, because for AC waveform, omega not equal to 0, so that ZL will have some finite value. So what will happen, that if you consider this path, that is series inductor and then load resistor RL, then AC will, in front of AC, there is a high impedance path, but in front of DC, there is low impedance path, right? So DC can easily pass and it will produce voltage drop across RL. But as inductor will provide very high impedance for the AC waveform, so most of the AC voltage will drop across this load resistor L, this inductor L. So that there will be very less amount of AC voltage which will reach up to this RL and will produce the fluctuations in the output, right? Obviously some fluctuations will be there. The inductor cannot completely remove the AC, but it will not allow the AC to pass to the output easily, right? So that's what I have written here. The summarization of the whole story is, an inductor is connected in series with the circuit so that it blocks the AC component and provides an easy path. Easy path means low resistance path to the DC to reach the destination. In this way, series inductor filter works. For detailed explanation, you just check the link. And for the shunt capacitor, what we do, instead of taking output directly across RL, we apply one capacitor which is parallelly connected with the load resistor. And in this case, what happens? You know that the impedance offered by the capacitor ZC equal to 1 by j omega C. So for DC, ZC will be what? 1 by J into 0 into C, because for DC omega, that is angular frequency, or you can say frequency of oscillation, is 0. So ZC equal to infinity. That means capacitor will not DC current to flow through it. And you know from the basic concept of physics itself that capacitor blocks DC. But for AC, omega will have some certain value. So J omega C will not be 0. So 1 by J omega C will have some certain value. That is, for AC waveform, that is ZC, or impedance offered by the capacitor, will have some finite value, right? So what will happen, suppose through this path AC and DC both are coming, now DC cannot flow through the capacitor, whole DC current will flow through the load resistor and will produce voltage drop across the load resistor. But the AC will find two ways: some AC current will flow through the capacitor and some of them will flow through the load resistor, right? So that means fluctuations will be somewhat reduced because some AC current is flowing through the capacitor. So that's what I have written here. A capacitor is connected in parallel to the circuit so that it bypasses the AC component. Bypass why? Because this some AC current is passing through the capacitor. Instead of whole AC current flowing through the load resistor, some amount is flowing through the capacitor, some amount is flowing through the load resistor. That means some current is bypassed. Okay.
That is what bypass means, right? So a capacitor is connected in parallel to the circuit so that it bypasses the AC component and provides infinite resistance in the path for DC component so that the DC cannot flow through that path, and DC can flow only through the load resistor RL. Okay, so I hope you have understood. Here you just keep in mind that provides infinite resistance in that path for which signal? For DC signal. Okay, so that the DC cannot flow through only the load. Okay, I hope you have understood. So the moral of the whole discussion is that to make exact DC waveform from pulsating DC in the filter, what we have to do with the load resistor, we have to add one inductor in series, or you can say add one capacitor in parallel. If you add one inductor in series, that will become series inductor filter. If you add one capacitor in parallel with the load resistor, that will become what? That will become shunt capacitive filter. Okay. Now, what is the idea scientists thought? That this can be implemented in the output of the rectifier, and this can reduce the ripples or fluctuations in the output. This type of circuit, that is shunt capacitive filter, also do the same. So why not combining both of them, and we can have this type of circuit. See, here in the load resistor, one capacitor is connected in shunt and one inductor is connected in series. That means this circuit is basically combination of this circuit and as well as this circuit. Okay, this is called L-section filter. Why L-section? See, if you consider inductor as this kind of wire and capacitor and RL as this, then it is looking like what? It is rotated L-shaped in English alphabet, right? So this is also called L-section filter. And this filter you have to implement in the output of the rectifier. Okay, so that I have written here rectifier output, and original output we are taking, that is overall output we are taking from this point, okay, that is across RL. So this is called L-section filter, which will have more, that is better performance, okay, because both the filter, that is series inductor, shunt capacitor, both the filters are working here, right? Now, another kind of configuration of filter scientists have tried to implement is L-section filter. What is that? Very simple. Just you consider the L-section filter, and you know that if you add one capacitor in shunt, it will help us to get lesser amount of fluctuations in the output, right? That is, it will help us to get the almost a pure DC from the pulsating DC. So in the L section filter, in the left hand side, scientists have added one more capacitor, and this is very important filter, and this will have more, that is better performance. Okay, so see, now if you consider this configuration, this capacitor, so one wire, then this inductor, one wire, then there are capacitor and load resistor, so two wires. If you modify somewhat, then it is almost looking like the mathematical expression pi, that is 22/7 or 3.14, as you know. So this is also called pi section filter. Okay, so these are the four types of filters which is whose application is huge, firstly implemented in electronics and communication engineering. One is series inductor, another one is shunt capacitor, another one is L-section, another one is pi section filter to get a pure DC from a pulsating DC. That is, this type of filters we apply at the output side of the rectifier. Okay, so I hope you have understood the filter operations, they are working, what are the filter configurations, how they work, and how we can implement those in multisim in detail. You just check my previous videos, so you will have a clear idea in this topic. Surely you must understand this topic, because these are basic building blocks in electronics and communication engineering. This is all for this video. For more videos related to electronics and communication engineering, please subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.